Japan's Ministry of Defense Equipment Office, under the Ministry of Defense, released a message on social media that the agency had recently successfully conducted a medium-caliber electromagnetic gun sea launch test in cooperation with the Japan Maritime Self-Defense Force, JMSDF. Japan's Equipment Department called the test the world's first shipboard electromagnetic gun test. Although the Japanese side did not disclose more details, but they said Japan will continue to promote the research and development of related technologies, so that in the future the technology will be used in the sea since the same time as the land-based weapons and equipment. This news immediately attracted widespread attention from the outside world. The reason is also very simple. The success of this test marks Japan officially became the United States, China, India, and Turkey, after the fifth completed electromagnetic gun firing test countries. And with the United States, India, Turkey, three countries have chosen to test on the ground is different. Japan will be a step forward to choose to test on the ship, which means that the country's electromagnetic gun technology has been quite mature. However, although the Japanese Equipment Agency called the test the world's first, but that's just what they call themselves. In fact, back in 2018, photos of the PLA's Ocean Hill landing ship installing a shipboard electromagnetic cannon were exposed. Although Chinese officials did not disclose specific details about the ship, it is widely believed that the first country in the world to complete shipboard electromagnetic cannon tests was China, not Japan. But although Japan is not the first country to play electromagnetic gun on board, but from the current stage of Japan's attitude towards electromagnetic gun technology, the probability is that they will be the first country that intends to rely on this technology in the naval field to other countries, especially China, to realize the bending of the road to overtake. This is not impossible, because from the current strategic situation facing Japan, Japan's Ministry of Defense, especially the Maritime Self-Defense Force for High-Performance Electromagnetic Artillery, does have a small demand. After all, with the Chinese Navy in the last 10 years in the crazy explosion, the PLA's surface ship force has made rapid progress. Not only in the number and tonnage reached the second level in the world after the U.S. Navy, in the performance of the ship's quality, the latest generation of 052D destroyers and 054B frigates have reached the world's first-class level. And like 055, this kind of 10,000 tons of destroyers, but also become the world's navy to lead a new round of development direction of the wind vane. In contrast, although the Japanese Navy has also built a lot of new ships in the last 10 years, but both the scale and quality are far inferior to the PLA. Even if there is a Zumo-class such red as helicopter frigate, riding, lightning carrier, big ships sitting in the town, the PLA and the sea, since the gap between the strength of the level has reached an insurmountable level. So much so that the latter is often flirted with domestically as the U.S. Navy 7th Fleet Anti-Submarine Detachment. In this case, the Japanese Ministry of Defense will inevitably fall into a kind of panic. After all, even if you do not take into account that there is a historical account between China and Japan, the United States of America's hardcore ally, identity is enough to make the sea must consider the possibility of military conflict between China and Japan. However, the problem is that Japan's military technology level is not high, coupled with some objective factors limitations, resulting in Japan, although the development of long-range anti-ship missiles, hypersonic missiles, and other cutting-edge weapons, but the research and development of these weapons and equipment production is still in a relatively slow state. Especially missile weapons. Restricted by the size of the domestic industrial system, Japan's self-developed missile production costs are very high. So much so that the United States sold to Japan's missiles, although there is a clear premium, but in the view of the Ministry of Defense, buy U.S. missiles than to buy domestic missiles to save money. Therefore, the Japanese Ministry of Defense has always hoped to be able to obtain a low-cost means to effectively enhance the combat effectiveness of the self-defense forces. As an artillery class of weapons, electromagnetic artillery also became the defense ministry in the eyes of the meat and potatoes. After all, from the point of view of the Ministry of Defense, the United States at the beginning of the 21st century. From sea to land, strategy has been proposed to use electromagnetic artillery to reduce the future cost of naval operations. The direct result of this idea was the DDG 1000 Jumbo Walter class destroyer, which was initially planned to be fitted with electromagnetic guns. Although the development of the electromagnetic gun as the core equipment in this program was not completed, which in turn led to the entire DDG 1000 becoming one of the biggest strategic mistakes of the U.S. Navy. But for the Ministry of Defense, the failure was only the DDG 1000, not the low-cost electromagnetic gun. As long as they can complete the development of the electromagnetic gun, and then rely on the Japanese territory near China's advantage, the Japanese Navy will have the ability to form a firepower advantage over the PLA's surface ships under certain conditions. Not to mention, as the PLA is armed with more and more anti-ship ballistic missiles and hypersonic missiles, and traditional anti-missile missiles are not very efficient at intercepting such targets, Japan's Defense Ministry is still trying to find ways to improve its own anti-missile capabilities, and among the many options to counter them, electromagnetic artillery is one of the most theoretically efficient weapons. Therefore, even if we do not consider the matter of letting the C-Self use electromagnetic artillery to attack the PLA, in the face of the PLA's missile threat, Japan's Defense Ministry also has the need to use electromagnetic artillery to improve its own anti-missile capabilities, to avoid the entire C-Self and the possible outbreak of Sino-Japanese conflict by the PLA rocket force in the harbor in a pot. Before, including the United States and China, have conducted electromagnetic gun-related verification experiments on land, and the United States and China are very early to the electromagnetic gun prototype mounted on the sea ship. Of course, in the public reports, we cannot query the two countries on the sea electromagnetic gun experiments reported. But in this regard, the Japanese Ministry of Defense said that China and the United States put this kind of electromagnetic gun mounted on the ship and did not carry out test firing at sea. Obviously a very arbitrary judgment. Then I do not say, never means I do not do. We are very familiar with is the Chinese Navy in 2018 on the Ocean Hill landing ship. On the bow of the 936 landing ship equipped with a modeling very unforgettable and electromagnetic gun carried out by the related experiments. In everyone's imagination, this electromagnetic gun has also been put on the future 055 improvement type, may be put into real use, and the United States is as early as in the planning of the DDG 1000 destroyer, thought of using electromagnetic gun as its main gun, to complete the low cost to the road to strike the task. The electromagnetic gun is the United States planning the true body of the AGS Advanced Naval Gun System. Only later the United States found it too difficult to develop, the AGS downgraded to a traditional 155mm gun, and eventually came to the present DDG 1000 no gun available a situation. In other words, China and the United States have actually accumulated a lot of experience in the use of electromagnetic guns at sea. But why up to now, China and the United States have not reported on electromagnetic gun experiments, and have not really put the electromagnetic gun installed pieces to use? Then here we have to mention a few constraints on the use of electromagnetic guns. First of all, regardless of electromagnetic rail gun or electromagnetic coil gun, now are still facing the problem of the gun sound burning candle. We all know that the principle of electromagnetic gun is to convert the electric energy through the magnetic field into the kinetic energy of the projectile, and the process of such a conversion requires a great deal of electric current, which also caused the current more difficult to solve the problem of electric current burning candle sound of the gun, that if can't be solved, then the life of this gun barrel will be very poor, and so also will not have practical effect. Secondly, the problem of energy storage, self-destructive energy storage and instantaneous outburst requirements are relatively high. Of course, this is relatively good solution. After all, China and the United States have completed the study of electromagnetic catapults, used in the electromagnetic gun is also very convenient, but more importantly, the electromagnetic gun is a very high requirement for the shells, due to the electromagnetic gun's strong acceleration, the current experimental Launch of the electromagnetic gun shells are most of the solid shells, and such as shells, and the shells will be very poor, so there is no practical effect. Solid shells, and such shells obviously do not have any envisioned including precision strikes, stronger destructive capacity, and so on such effects, that is to say, the electromagnetic cannon may still have a great distance from the practical. So does this condemn the technology to death? Not really. To China's academician Ma Weiming as the representative of some of our advanced scientists, they envision that the electromagnetic gun in another way to use, the use of large electromagnetic coil catapult device to launch missiles, to give the missile with a certain initial velocity, can make the missile volume to do smaller, the range to do more far, or is the use of electromagnetic coil catapult device to launch rockets. In the vision of academician Ma Weiming, the use of electromagnetic catapult device can make the long-distance fire to reach 2,000 km amazing range, rockets up to 2,000 km, which I am afraid is the future development of electromagnetic artillery a correct direction.